How would you have fared in this new NBA in the land of the point guard, the guys that you see playing that position today?
Oh, that was 40.
I was saying, remember when you're asking? Think about that.
Well, I just want to hear it. That's the whole point, because I know my man.
I would average 40. And the reason is this. I played like James Harden and Westbrook, right?
That you did.
But they don't have Shaquille O'Neal's, McGlure's to stop me. They don't have that big man to actually
small ball
to keep me out of there.
If I'm
scoring 45 and there's a Shaq and an Alonzo Mourning that's coming behind him,
right.
You don't have that. Now your biggest guy is your four man. And now you're trying to switch you're switching your biggest guy on
you.
No, 1-4 flat. Meet you at the rim. It would have been the James Harden without the dribbles. I don't need to bang. I don't need to do this. I'm just gonna go and go.
I'm just gonna go. Yeah, you didn't mess around. It was this.
Yeah.
And that's where that name came with, because I would just seen you so many times just get that thing, just that wrist flick, or you was just bop bop, and it was like.
And then now with the guard and I set in the post. Now I'm sitting in the post. And that help guy is not a big anymore because all bigs are lifted. So I was like, oh, I'll be in the 37,
I think
40s.
You would have.
You know, because there's, yeah. You know, it's just dependent on the game. I was like, the way my style was, it was either get to the basket, three, right. Mid-range.
The reason why I agree with you on this, and I really do agree, is because of what you said, but I also think there's the number of possessions in the game now.
Mm-hmm.
So now this game is being played like that. This. That's more shots in the game. Mm-hmm. That style of play really fits you. And like nobody made a big fuss about it back then as much as they probably should have, but you was making shots from the center circle. I remember one vividly in Atlanta, I wanted to kill you. This dude we was trapping him. He's in the circle, dancing. We about to run a trap to him. He just shoots. And it hits all. I'm like, he didn't even watch it go in, actually. He shot it and he left. And it hit all that. And I looked at Woody and I'm like, I don't know what defense. I ain't got no. That's the best scouting report I'm going to give you on him. Because I don't know what. And he was doing that, you know, before it became this real big deal.
Yeah, they I said, hey, listen, I started runs. Instead of turning it into a whole they other into, thing.
They do it like, you know,
that's just a turnaround right now.
I've seen you do that, you know, back in the day where you would pull just from. Places I couldn't believe. I remember Joe Johnson would do that sometimes because he's just so strong. It's just like,
man.
He would do this to you. That's where ISO Joe came from. We were playing Boston and they was doing the same thing to us in the playoff. Hey, KG trapping them and posing them. Joe just finally said, this is the best shot I'm going to get. And he was roping them. And I was like, that's a shooter there. Mm-hmm. And now we got Dame doing that.
But that was the funniest. People didn't understand. Like, people were like, why are you 1-4 flat? I was like, because you didn't realize, like,
They're running, they're trapping,
we there's defense running. Set. Like, I don't hide. Like, they knew the game plan. The game plan is they didn't
we was not
watch
him
that.
Play.
So it's like.
And you still drop 40, 50.
We have to do
down.
1-4. This is the best option right now.
T-Mac would do that.
Yep,
T-Mac would be doing that.
We threw the whole sink at T-Mac when he had 62.
There's nothing you can do.
Yeah, I tried to guard him. We put Brendan Haywood on him. He's sitting like.
What am I doing?
Like, it was like, okay, Brendan, you gonna challenge a shot. We're gonna push him to the basket. He said, all right, three.
That's 6'10.
Further three.
6'10 with handle, over the top, rope.
Unguardable.
You know, and so it was guys that was doing that stuff, but now it's just a part of the game.
It's a part of the game.
Well, say this, and at that, not to cut you off, but at
that
time.
Because people would kill you if you do that too much.
Yes. Okay, well, yeah. We heard your point of view from your sideline. What did Eddie and those guys say when you were in your huddle?
Nothing.
Because you got to remember,
I was in the gym 24/7.
Yeah.
So before practice, Eddie's seeing where I'm shooting from. They're man, watching me. Them. So when I did it in the game, it was like, that's what he does. So like,
and it went in.
But that's why, like, with my teammates, we never argued about shots because we practiced them.
Uh-huh. Like, so they knew what you could do.
So if Deshaun Stevenson was 1-for-8 and he got it and he
still
shot it and he did this in the middle of his shot, that's what he did. We're not going to...
You don't want to disrupt that. That's part of your success.
That's what he does. Karan, I pass him. Like, when I made passes to Karan, I knew I wasn't getting an assist because he had a rhythm.
He's going
to
dance.
He got to get the ball wide open.
He going
to dance.
Boom, boom.
and shoot the same shot. Like, wide open, he gonna bounce it, the guy's gonna get on him, he's gonna pump fake, the guy's gonna jump, he's gonna jump while he jumps, same shot. He gets the 2 points, no assists. But that was part of it. So
that was his game.
That was his game. He couldn't mess it up. Like, yo, shoot the ball. There was none of that chasing assists. I don't care about your chase. Let me
get I'm about to play how I gotta play. Because if you think about it, probably one of the most unorthodox players in the league was Antoine Jameson.
Mm-hmm.
But you just had to give him his room to do what he do.
And you just got to watch it. That's what I said. Like,
it was unbelievable what he would do, though.
You had to be smart and understand this is their games. Like, so we didn't, there was no bumping. Like, people were like,
You never heard nothing come out of y'all.
You're going to average five assists? Like, I average way more than five assists. That's five assists on paper.
Right.
But listen, I have a guy who averages 20. I have another guy who averages 19. I have a guy who averages 12. Another guy who averages 13.
That ain't happening because the ball's staying. Yeah. Somebody's passing the ball.